Hi, I'm Kyle Shannon, founder and CEO of Storyvine. And we created Storyvine to solve the problem of creating short professional videos automatically. Sit back, learn about how to do it, and have fun. It's going to be great.
Hello, Storymakers, and thank you for stopping by to watch our How to Use Storyvine training video. Today, I'm going to cover three things. First, getting started. This is all about choosing your environment, your lighting, and filming style. Second, I'm going to explore the Storyvine app by walking you through our video guide. Lastly, I'm going to share with you our pro video tips to ensure that you get the highest quality video. Getting started. This is all about your environment, your lighting, and your filming style. So when choosing an environment, choose something interesting, engaging, but not distracting. As I move throughout this video, you'll see I have a lot of movement with my backgrounds. Next is your lighting. It's always good to try to find natural lighting, but sometimes you need to have some artificial illumination as well. So don't be shy, grab a backlight, grab your phone, turn that flashlight on if needed, and give yourself your best face forward with good lighting. So now we just need to choose our filming style. We've got a few options. The first and most recognizable is selfie style. If you don't want to go the traditional route and do handheld, one trip is you can put your phone up on a shelf or on a tripod and you can get a nice stable frame. The second is buddy style. And this is you, a friend, a coworker, family member, sitting in a comfortable environment with someone who you trust and they're recording you. And last, pro style. We refer to these people as trained mobile producers. They're educated in the Storyvine system, fluent in filming best practices, and oftentimes carry around video accessories and gear to ensure the highest quality of video output every time. Now that you guys have gotten started by choosing your environment, lighting, and filming style, let's jump in and explore the Storyvine app. The first thing you want to do is enter your email address, and you'll see a video guide come up. If that's not the video guide you're looking for, simply hit Change Video Guide. Now that we're in our video guide options, you'll see a carousel that you can scroll through, moving left to right. Once you see the template you'd like to access, go ahead and select it. Once you've selected it, you have the option to preview exactly what the final video would look like. You can go full screen by clicking the preview icon above. Below over here, you have a synopsis of what your filming takes or segments are going to look like. In this one, we'll take a picture, we'll film our video greeting, and then we'll do a little happy dance. So I feel ready, I'm gonna hit get started. Now you've gone into the data entry portion. A few different options in this template. I'm gonna choose congratulations. Depending on which template you access, you'll have different variable fields. So just be mindful of that. Next on here, I'm gonna put in a message, which is congratulations on your promotion. And the name of the recipient, which is Monique. And this greeting card is from Wolfgang and myself. When you're ready, hit accept to continue. Now we're going to move to the prompts within the video guide. Let's take a look at what's on screen here. The first thing I want to point out is myself, my doppelganger, within this outline. We call this Gary the Guide. He tells you exactly where to stand in frame. And if you jump over here, you see this kind of do not enter box. It simply means do not enter, because what will happen is there'll be a creative element or a graphic on the final output video, like a logo, and if you're standing there, it could cover your face. So that's what that means. Next, we've got two icons over here. If I select the top one, that'll switch into selfie mode. Or if I hit the bottom one, I can go ahead and upload a photo from my camera roll if I prefer that. The last thing I want to point out is our prompting guide. You can go ahead and remove it or bring it back up at any time by doing what I just did there. And now let's go ahead and move into taking a picture. We're live in camera, ready to snap our photo. As you see, we've got Gary the outline and our obstructor view here. We can turn that on and off by selecting this icon so the Do Not Enter box can appear or disappear very easily. When you're ready to move forward, you can hit continue, or if you're not happy with the photo, go ahead and retake it. You've wrapped up prompt number one. Let's take a look at prompt number two, which is filming your video greeting. You have all the same interface, except for now you have a record button. When you're ready to begin recording, simply click it. Now we're live. We've got a timer showing us how long we've been filming. And when we wrap up our segment here, we're gonna have a few options to look at. The first being replay. The second being redo a clip. This means you don't like it. Or you continue if you're happy. I recommend you always hit replay. This allows you to check the lighting and the audio quality before moving on. Give us an example. Hey, it's Larisha and
Wolfgang.
And we just wanted to congratulate you on your recent promotion, Monique.
Great job.
So I'm happy with it, so I can go ahead and continue on. You will continue to film each video segment as I demonstrated here until you've wrapped up your entire video. Once you have, simply click upload. When you upload, you'll see a status bar showing you exactly the progress. When it reaches 100%, that means it's securely in our system. You always have the option to film another story while it's uploading. If you click this, it'll take you back to the beginning and you can begin your next video. Pro video tip number one. Remember, whatever you record inside the Storyvine app will appear in the final output video. Kyle, let's go ahead and start our story. Action!
Hi, my name's Kyle Shannon.
So what happened there was I hit record and then said action. So that's gonna show up in the final video and not look or sound very good. To do it properly, you wanna use nonverbal cues. Let me give you a demonstration of that. 3, 2, 1.
Hi, my name's Kyle Shim.
And now we've got a video ready to be uploaded to the Storyvine system. Pro video tip number two. Avoid filming in front of bright windows, because if you do, you will end up looking like you're part of the Witness Protection Program.
Snitches get stitches.
Oh, hey guys, didn't see you there. You ready for pro video tip number three? This one's all about choosing interesting backgrounds. You wanna avoid filming too close to or directly in front of a beige wall, otherwise you're gonna look like a prisoner mugshot.
I'm innocent.
Pro video tip number four. You want to make sure that you hold your mobile device correctly so you don't accidentally muffle the sound. Your microphones are located here. The natural way that most people want to hold it is something like this. It kind of cup their hand, and you can distort the sound when doing this. The correct way, you want to make sure that you don't touch your microphones like this. There's space between my hand and the microphones. Pro video tip number five. Be natural. One of the hallmarks of Storyvine is their authenticity. Just you and your mobile device connecting with the audience. One of the quickest ways to lose this is to overscript because, well, it creates a disconnection, just like I did right there. So, practice beforehand, in front of a friend, in front of the mirror, know your bullet points, and then just be yourself. And remember to always look into the camera. It's like making eye contact.